Then comes the round 5. Okay, it is basically the face interview round. Okay, they eventually start from the basic concept, like since I code in Java, so they mostly asked about the Java DSA part, and in the DSA they even go till graphs and hash map. Hi guys, myself Shubham Sharma, and in today's video we would be discussing about Relevel backend examination. I would be describing you each and every rounds in details with my personal experience. Okay, so watch the video from starting till the end and you would be having a crystal clarity about the Relevel backend examination. There is added advantage for you, for those who are watching this video, because I would be providing you the link for the round 2 questions in the description, and I would also be providing the link for round 3 and 4 questions of Relevel backend examination. Okay, so if you want to have the questions, then you may click on the link in the description and get it. I have downloaded the brochure from the official website of Relevel. In order to have the detailed analysis of it, let's move on to our screen. So as on the screen you may see like backend development examination. See, there is an age criteria, as you may see here, that is, the person who is giving the Relevel examination should be under 35 years of age and greater than 18 years of age. Okay, so some of you were asking me about the age criteria in the comment section. So this is the age criteria, that is 18 to 35. As I told you, there would be basically 5 rounds for Relevel examination. Round 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, round 1 and 2 would start basically from 8:30 a.m. till 11:30 a.m. And if you qualify round 1 and round 2 combined, that is, you would be needing so as to score 200 marks out of 350 marks. So if you score greater than 200, then you would be moving to round 3 and 4, okay, which would be basically a development round. Here you would be getting so as to develop what? The backend features. But remember, you would be having only 3 choices, okay, for the backend development. First is Python Django, the second is Node.js, and the third is Java Spring Boot. Okay, so you should remember this, because only these frameworks you would be allowed so as to develop with. Though I was not able to develop more features in it because I'm not into much web development part. I'm basically into the app development part. Okay, and I was not knowing any of these frameworks. Okay, I have just learned the glimpse of Node.js. Okay, with that only I have developed the basic feature. So the score for my Relevel backend examination, some of you were asking what was my score. See, for the front end it was just qualified, you may say, okay, 700 plus. But for the backend examination, since I was not knowing any of these framework, okay, then also my score was 560. See, the development round is for 350 marks. Okay, so you may assume that I have just got 560 marks out of 650 marks. Okay, because that development part was almost a vain for me. I have mainly scored through the initial round, that is round 1 and round 2, then through the round 5, that is interview. In all 3 combinations of round, I nearly scored 560 marks, and I would be sharing the screenshot of it. So you may have a sort of trust on me, and I would be reattempting it once I learn any of these development framework, that is either Node.js or Java Spring Boot. Okay, I would be reattempting it and would update you after I reattempt it. Okay, then comes the round 5. Okay, it is basically the face interview round. Okay, in the comment section many of you were asking what were the questions asked in the round 5, that is the interview round. See, for the front end it has been too long for me. I'm not able to recall much of the questions asked there. But for the back end, since I have just given few days back, I can recall some of the questions out. Interviewer were too polite and it almost took 1 hour for the interview process. They eventually start from the basic concept, like since I code in Java, so they mostly asked about the Java DSA part, and in the DSA they even go till graphs and hash map. The level of questions for the interview was quite good. The interview also asked about the various OOPs concept, okay, and the difference between them, and asked me so as to differentiate between them and how would I apply those, what, the OOPs concept. I think all of you must be knowing that. Then some of the questions which I remembered out are the difference between static and final keyword, what the use of super keyword, okay, what is overriding, Okay, these were the some of the questions asked in the interview. Then some of questions were related to interface. Then after that, the interviewer jumped to the development part. Okay, she asked me about the project I developed. So I basically told about the development projects. And she just started asking questions about that. Okay, so you should be good with the project you have developed. These were the some of the questions asked to me in the interview. I would urge you, all of the viewers who would be giving the Relevel examination, so as to type the questions that are uniquely asked you in the comment section. I would specially urge for it because it would be much helpful for the new applicant who would be applying there. If we collaboratively help each other, then we would be together successful. You may type about the questions asked to you in the round 2, that is the coding round. Okay, any question which you remember of Relevel examination, just type in the comment section. All of us would be happy to read that and would be thankful to you. Then the basic criteria for giving the Relevel backend examination is have under 3 years of experience, are actively looking for first or the next job, and you should be above 18. And for the basic application procedure, you may simply visit the Relevel website and book your slot via giving a live resume. The round 1, or we may say back to basics, its duration is 45 minutes and the maximum mark allotted to it is 150 marks. And the questions asked are basically 35 in numbers, and the questions are asked basically from computer networks, operating system, basic programming, databases. Since this exam is basically related to backend exam, then comes access your algo. Its duration is 1.5 hour and the marks allotted to it are 200, and you may code in any of the programming language you want to code with. There are a lot of programming languages given there. Then comes the create your feature round, in which the duration is 2 hours and the marks allotted to it are basically 200 marks. The framework allowed to you are basically Node.js, Python Django or Java Spring Boot. And you would be basically provided with a boilerplate code, and you have to code what is asked in the question. Basically there would be 2 questions and you have to attempt or make the changes as asked in the question 1 and 2. Then comes the round 4, or we may say the optimizer feature round, in which the duration is 1.5 hours and the marks allotted to it are basically 150 marks. And in this round, basically there would be one question and they would be asking you as to develop a feature, or we may say optimize it and make more scalable. You have to do those changes in the web application you had been given with. Then comes the round 5, or you may say face the interview round, in which the duration is 1 hour and the marks allotted to it are basically 300 marks. And the shortlisting criteria is basically who scores 700 plus marks, known as shortlisted candidate, and would be provided with a Relevel profile, after which you would be having the interviews with various companies out there. These are the some of the companies which would be hiring there, and there are basically 350 companies hiring through it, and the CTC given through it is 15 LPA. And if you want to check the syllabus for it, I would be providing the documentation link in the description. You may check out the syllabus too. Okay, so this was all about the Relevel backend examination. Hope you liked the video. Then make sure to subscribe to the channel. I will meet you in the next video. Until then, bye-bye. दुनिया या उसे याद रखे जो गुनी याद रखे मरने के ही बात सबके गुण याद रखे सकते लौटे किसे बात की अकड़ा तुझे फंजी बने नूनिया तो सुने याद रखें।